My name is Peter Karp, and I direct the Bioinformatics Research Group at SRI International, a private nonprofit research institute in Menlo Park, California. This webinar series will introduce you to the information present in BioCyc and to the many tools available to help you search and analyze information in BioCyc. Our overall mission at BioCyc is to provide you with up-to-date and comprehensive information on microbial genomes and metabolic networks, together with powerful bioinformatics tools for searching, visualizing, and analyzing that information. We think you will find that BioCyc is both a highly functional web portal for microbial genomes and is quite easy to use. This first webinar in the series will give you an overview of the functionality present in BioCyc. This webinar will cover an overview of the data content of BioCyc and its software tools. The BioCyc data content consists of imported data and computationally inferred data and manually curated data. And the BioCyc software tools cover genomics, pathways, regulation, omics data analysis, comparative analysis, and a tool called Smart Tables. BioCyc is a collection of 17,000 pathway genome databases. Each pathway genome database, or PGDB, combines information about the metabolic pathways and reactions of an organism, its enzymes and transporters, its genes and replicons, and in some cases, its regulatory network. We divide BioCyc into three tiers to try to describe their quality levels. Tier one are the very highly curated databases, which in some cases have undergone two-person decades of curation. The Tier 2 databases are moderately curated, and there are 50 of these. And Tier 3 databases are all the rest. They are computationally derived. And overall, the data in BioCyc has been curated from 95,000 publications, and our databases cover 2,400 human microbiome project microbes. The BioCyc database content consists of information imported from several external databases, including RefSeq and UniProt and the regulatory database, RegTransBase. It also consists of computationally inferred information, such as inferred reactions and metabolic pathways and operons. It also includes literature-curated information in the Tier 1 and Tier 2 databases, where we have reviewed and corrected and supplemented the computational inferences performed above. And in particular, we focus in our curation efforts on recently determined experimental gene functions. And different databases will vary in their mix of content. Now, BioCyc will have a variable number of sequenced strains per species. For example, we have more than 500 E. coli genomes, but only 39 for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Some of our PGDBs contain gene essentiality data, and there are 7 PGDBs that have more than 200 transcriptional regulatory interactions. How are the Tier 2 and Tier 3 databases created? That procedure starts with an annotated genome for the organism, such as in the form of a GenBank entry. Our Pathway Tool software then converts the gene and protein information in the GenBank entry into the PGDB format. Next, we run several prediction components of Pathway Tools that predict the metabolic reactions, transport reactions, metabolic pathways, and pathway hole fillers. They also predict operons, compute orthologs, and compute PFAM domains across the genome. Next, we run a series of import tools that import a variety of data from external databases, including regulatory data, subcellular locations, gene ontology terms, protein features, links to these various databases, organism phenotype data and gene essentiality data, and in some cases, phenotype microarray data. If BioCyc does not contain an organism that you'd like to have a database for, you can request that we add it by sending a support request from the bottom of most BioCyc pages, or you can build the database yourself using a locally installed copy of Pathway Tools. The tests that our curators perform include importing additional protein functions from UniProt. They perform literature searches for new gene functions and pathways. They author what we call mini review summaries, or one or a few paragraphs summarizing what's known in the literature about a protein or a pathway. And they'll insert citations and evidence codes. They also update various database fields like the gene names or synonyms, protein functions, activators, inhibitors, KM values, a really wide assortment of information. They also enter new enzyme reaction associations. They'll rerun the metabolic pathway prediction based on changes to the protein functions, and then they'll review the predicted pathways. They'll also review and extend transporter and transport reaction associations. They will also define new transcription factor binding sites in the databases and promoters, and define events that regulate transcription initiation and other processes. Our flagship database within BioCyc is the EcoCyc E. coli database, which has been derived from 36,000 publications. It contains many dimensions of annotation for the E. coli genome, including 3,100 pages of mini review summaries, as well as many literature citations, gene ontology annotations, protein features such as active sites, multimeric complexes, metabolic pathways, 3,900 instances of regulation of gene expression and regulation of protein activity. There are 8 gene essentiality data sets and 437 growth observations describing the growth of E. coli under alternative nutrient conditions. But of course, that's not just E. coli that is curated. Here's an example of a Salmonella protein whose function was recently discovered. It's a fructose lysine glucolysine transporter, and BioCyc describes the protein subunit structure, provides a mini review summary with a number of literature citations, describes all the different transport events, and provides gene ontology terms as well. Here's an example of a sulfate reduction pathway from Senecococcus elongatus, a curated pathway that includes a substantial mini review summary. It shows the operons of all genes in the pathway. If we click on this first reaction here, we go to a BioCyc reaction page that shows the reaction equation along with coloring of the conserved moieties. If we click on metabolite in this diagram, we go to a metabolite page that shows the metabolite structure, as well as Smiles and Inchi, as well as if we click on the reactions tab, we list all the reactions that are known to act on this compound. We also have a tier 2 curated database for Bacillus subtilis. And here's a curated transcriptional regulator for Bacillus subtilis. And if we go to the Regulon page of the Regulon tab of the protein page, we see all the known operons in B. subtilis that this transcriptional regulator controls. Let me quickly introduce you to some important BioCyc tools that will be described more fully in later webinars in the series. These tools are useful both for navigating the genome, metabolic, regulatory information space and for analyzing high-throughput datasets. BioCyc has a number of genome informatics tools, including many different searches for gene and protein and RNA information and a genome site search. There's a gene information page and a transcription unit page that shows regulatory sites and interactions. There's BLAST search, sequence pattern search, and sequence alignment. There's an ability to map SNPs to their nearest genes and show the effects on translation. And there's a genome browser that can zoom from the full chromosome in one screen to the sequence level. It has a comparative mode shown here where we can align genome regions at a common gene. And there's a tracks facility. We can also paint omics data onto the genome map and produce a genome poster for an organism. For pathway informatics operations, there is a pathway search tool and a pathway information page. The user can customize pathway diagrams for publication. There's an ability to create personalized multi-pathway diagrams where you specify what pathways you want to combine together. And there's an ability to perform comparative pathway analyses. There's also a reaction search tool and a reaction information page that includes reaction atom mappings. There's a metabolite search tool and a metabolite information page. There's a zoomable organism-specific metabolic map diagram that includes the ability to generate a organism-specific metabolic map poster. There's a metabolic route search tool that computes optimal paths from a starting metabolite that you specify to an ending metabolite. And there's an ability to execute quantitative metabolic flux models. Let me now show you the organism-specific metabolic map diagram. This is the metabolic map diagram for Bacillus subtilis, and this tool is zoomable in real time. You can zoom in on pathways of interest and move around. As you zoom in, you get more and more information. And you can also paint omics data onto this tool. Every organism gets its own organism-specific metabolic map diagram. There are also a variety of regulatory informatics tools that let us capture regulatory sites and multiple types of regulatory interactions. There are regulatory queries, and there's a regulatory network browser. Here we've performed a regulatory query in the E. coli database to find all enzymes and highlight them in red whose gene is negatively regulated by FNR. BioCyc contains multiple omics data analysis tools that I'll review for you now. Given an omics dataset, which could be transcriptomics or metabolomics or proteomics, you can paint that data onto individual pathway diagrams, onto our multi-pathway diagrams or pathway collages, and onto the full metabolic map diagram. We also have a tool called the Omics Dashboard, and our Smart Table facilities lets you manage gene sets, metabolite sets, protein sets, and create a spreadsheet view of them that's connected back to the database. And you can do transformations within smart tables, like transforming a list of genes into a list of all the pathways that those genes are in, or transform a list of metabolites into a list of all the pathways those metabolites are in. You can also perform enrichment analyses to compute what pathways are statistically overrepresented in a gene set or a metabolite set. You can also do enrichment analysis for GO terms and for regulators in gene sets. There are a number of metabolomics-only operations within BioCyc, such as a number of different metabolite search tools. There's a metabolite translation service that translates identifiers from one metabolite database to another, like from BioCyc to KEG. There's also an ability to compute pathway covering sets for a set of metabolites. Now, we saw before the cellular overview diagram. This is the human version. It combines the metabolic map and transporters. It's automatically generated for every organism, and it's organism specific. It's also zoomable and queryable using a tool to the right. Here we've painted a transcriptomics data set onto the cellular overview, so that the reaction edges in the diagram are colored to reflect the transcript levels for those genes. And if the user clicks on a given reaction, you first see a pop-up that identifies what reaction that is and what enzyme. And you can then click to get a graph like this showing the levels at different time points of these transcripts. You can also run this tool in an animated mode using these controls over here, where the highlighted edges change with every time point as you play through the animation, and you can start it and stop it and change the speed. Here's a pathway collage with gene expression data. Here's a pathway diagram with gene expression data. Here's metabolomics data painted onto the full metabolic map information. So for metabolomics data, the data is painted onto the nodes, the dots in the diagram, instead of the reaction edges. Now, the omics dashboard is a new interactive tool for analysis of gene expression or proteomics or metabolomics data or reaction fluxes. And it lets the user understand an omics data set at multiple levels. You can see a very high level view of the omics data set, but also drill down into very detailed levels. This is a picture of the first window that you see for the omics dashboard. It consists of a series of panels. So there's a biosynthesis panel and a degradation panel and a cellular processes panel. And each panel contains a set of plots or subsystems. So for example, within biosynthesis, there's amino acid biosynthesis, nucleotide biosynthesis, etc. Within a plot, the vertical lines are different time points, and the dots are different genes. Now, there are about 130 genes in E. coli amino acid biosynthesis, which is far too many for the eye to be able to see. So what we do is to compute the average expression levels of the entire system and plot those using the large dots. So if you let your eye follow the large dots, you can see what's happening over time to each of the cellular systems. You can very quickly see which systems are going up and which systems are going down. Now, let's say we're interested in seeing more information about amino acid biosynthesis. Well, if we click on amino acid biosynthesis, we first get this diagram to the left, which is organized in exactly the same way as just what we just saw. But now each individual amino acid is broken out in a separate plot. Again, individual genes are plotted along the vertical bars for each time point, and we compute averages and plot them using the large dots. So we can see what's happening to alanine biosynthesis, arginine biosynthesis, etc. Now, if we want a still greater level of detail for arginine biosynthesis, we can click on it, and we get this display to the right, which plots the individual expression levels of individual genes within this pathway. Now, I'd like to give you a quick overview of the Smart Tables facility. Smart Tables lets us collect and save lists of database objects, which could be genes, metabolites, pathways, and even sequence regions. You can explore them interactively, filter them, combine them, transform them into related objects, and you can keep them private or share them with the public or with specific collaborators. You can also perform omics analyses with Smart Tables. Now, the way you create a Smart Table is either by importing data from a file, tab delimited file, or creating a Smart Table from query results. Now, here's a gene Smart Table that has three columns, the gene name, the product name, and the pathways containing that gene. Now, here's a Smart Table created as a list of metabolites, where we're seeing the metabolite name and links to other online databases. Here, we have a different set of columns displayed for our metabolite Smart Table. We're looking at both the molecular weight and the monoisotopic molecular weight. And for this metabolite Smart Table, we're looking at the Smiles string and the structure of the compound. We can also manipulate genes and sequences, show the DNA sequence for a given gene, as well as its genome coordinates and accession number. And we can perform transformations where we start with a metabolite list. We transform metabolites to reactions of those metabolites, then transform the reactions to pathways containing the metabolites, and finally transform the pathways into genes within the pathway. In the next webinar in the series, we will introduce you to tools for searching BioCyc.